Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm gonna answer some questions that you had in the last video about this Kaihong BotBook. So one of the most common questions I got is, are you getting paid for this? And the truth is, I am not getting paid, but the Kaihong company sent me this computer as a review example for free. And this is the first product I have ever received for free. Everything else I have paid for in all of my videos. And I should have been more clear in my previous video. I put it in the description, but I should have mentioned it. But to be honest, I have been looking at this computer for a while and I really want to get it, but I couldn't justify the cost. So when the opportunity arose that they could give me one for free if I made a review out of it, I could not say no. Let's move on. Next question is, what is the story behind the red K? I had a discussion both on YouTube and on Bilibili what this red K stands for. And I asked the company, and you will see this icon if this is a company reply or if it's my reply. But they basically said the K, red K, is just branding. It has no special story, means nothing. So there you go. Can OpenHarmony be considered a Linux distribution? According to the OpenHarmony official documentation, OpenHarmony is an open source distributed operating system. Not the traditional Linux distribution. It supports multiple kernels, the lightweight Light OS kernel and also the Linux kernel, and also the Linux kernel for bigger devices. But it doesn't market itself as a Linux distro in the way that Ubuntu or Fedora does, for example. Next. What is the status of the x86 version? Will there be a downloadable ISO? So I didn't mention this in my last video, but some of you know, but there is an x86 version ongoing that Kaihong is developing. It has already gone out to a small group of developers, but it's not freely downloadable yet. In order to get into this group, you have to apply and you have to be kind of handpicked. But it's in a close beta stadium, and sometime later it will be released, which is kind of cool because I think everyone wants to try an x86 version. Next. How does the apps get into the Kaihong App Store? So right now, the apps are tested and adopted by the Kaihong team themselves. After they are happy or satisfied, they will publish it. So there is no kind of user cannot upload to the App Store now. It's the Kaihong development team that releases the apps to the App Store. Next. Does the Kaihong OS support running Windows as a virtual machine? Right now it doesn't, but it is something that is currently being planned, but it's not available yet. Next. What framework is the graphical interface built on? So this came up a lot. There was a lot of guesses and stuff, but it's Arc UI. The framework is built on Arc UI. It's completely open source and it's a part of the OpenHarmony ecosystem. So you can check it out for yourself. Next. Who is the main target of this device? This device is mainly targeted for developers at the moment. So it's designed for learning and development. So it's a development machine. Next. Can Kaihong OS run APK application via the mobile engine? Yes, APKs can already be installed via the mobile engine, though the UI support is still being polished. Does the Kaihong OS support installing and running Linux graphical applications? No, not yet. Package management for Linux is still under development. Next. What hardware specs does the Kaihong BotBook come with? I will show you here on the screen, and you can read for yourself. But this is it. Next. What kind of battery life can a user expect? So Kaihong is quite lightweight. So with moderate use, coding, browsing, handling documents, I think in my experience, it handles about a day of battery. If you use it more heavily, of course, it won't probably last a day. Next, English support or internationalization plans? Right now, but since OpenHarmony is an international open source project, multi-language support will most likely come in the future. For now, if you don't speak Chinese, you might find this OS a little bit limiting. So next, what is the app ecosystem like? Compared to, say, Android or Linux. So the Kaihong App Store is small very small compared to Linux or Android. Mobile Engine helps fill the gap a little bit, but it's still very much early days.
Next.
How is Kaihong OS updated? So updates are handled via the built-in updater, which patches and improvements pushed very regularly. Since it's a developer-focused product, there might be frequent and experimental patches, mental stuff than on a consumer laptop. But how does this one compare to, say, Harmony OS? So Kaihong OS is based on OpenHarmony, the open source project, whereas Harmony OS is, although it's based on OpenHarmony, it's a commercial implementation. So think of Kaihong OS more as develop-facing, experimental, while Harmony OS is more polished and it's consumer-facing. And the last question is, where can I get this machine? So, and does it ship worldwide? You can buy it online through Kaihong's own store, mall. I will drop a link in the description. Okay, so that's a wrap. Thank you for Kaihong for answering the questions I sent them and for sending me this laptop for review. And I'm very interested to see what comes. As I said, it's very early days. And I'm gonna see what updates come along. It's gonna be exciting, I think. If there's any more questions, you can write them below. I will try to answer them, or I will try to get some answers to them. Anyways, thank you for watching. See you next one. Bye-bye.